Although Uber and Lyft do not allow unaccompanied minors in rides, there are several alternatives to have an Uber or Lyft-like service for these minors. Hey everyone, my name is Chris and welcome to Real Rideshare Stories. And today we're going to be talking about a few of the different companies that do allow unaccompanied minors and children. And that's part of their business model is to be able to transport children to and from places safely with better vetting when it comes to drivers. And it's designed for it, unlike Uber and Lyft, which state clearly in their TOS that no unaccompanied minors are allowed at any point during a ride, and therefore you're supposed to cancel when it comes to Uber and Lyft. But because of these alternatives, that means it's another avenue for drivers to earn money. Now, this video is not sponsored by any of them. They don't even know I'm making this video, but I just want to share with you the other opportunities out there, because as a gig worker, you want to sign up for as many as you can. And if you enjoy certain ones over other ones, well, that's just a good thing, and you know where and when to go out, make the most money, and it's just good to have multiple apps running at the same time. So we're going to discuss a few of those real quick, and if you want any more information, just do a simple Google search, and you'll be able to see if it's available in your area, if you're going to be able to qualify, and what the requirements are. Now, there's four companies that I'm going to talk about. I only know of the four. I haven't really done too much research in it. If you have any other research or any information and want to share that, please comment below. I'm just giving this information, like I said. So if you want to sign up for these different companies, then you have the option if they're available in your area and you meet those requirements. So the first one is Hop Skip Drive. Now, this company has been around for a while, and they actually say this is not an Uber for kids or a Lyft for kids. The reason why they say that is because they say that drivers are vetted much more. There's more safety standards. There's a lot more things and requirements that drivers have to go through in order to be a hop, skip, and drive driver. Now, the second company not only provides rides, but it also can provide sitters. So it actually does more than just the rides. And that is called Kango, K-A-N-G-O. And again, this is something where you can schedule a ride or a sitter or childcare, depending on what your needs are. And also, that means that as a gig worker, you can sign up to be a driver or a sitter. The third company that I'm going to say today is Jump Rides, and that's Jump R-Y-D-Z. It's a little bit different than Jump Ride, which you might think of Uber, but this is Jump Rides. And this, again, is a family ride-sharing app. And the fourth one that I'm going to be talking about is called Ruby Rides. And this is, again, another family rideshare service. Not only do some of these allow for children and unaccompanied minors to be able to get rides to and from certain locations, they also provide sitters, but they also provide for elderly. So in the event that a family member is too old and can't drive anymore, or something happened and they still need to get around to and from doctor's offices, or this, that, and the other place, maybe the grocery store, whatever it is, then they're able to get rides that way as well too. Now, if you want any more information on these four companies and to see if it's something that will be a fit for you, link's gonna be in the description below so you can check them out. If you wanna check out all of them and see if they're available in your area, if you wanna see if you meet the requirements, and if you even wanna try signing up to drive for one of these companies, and remember, this is more than just an Uber or Lyft. This is something where you're going to transport children, unaccompanied minors, to and from locations to help the family out. So there's going to be a lot more vetting, a lot more safety protocol, and a lot more to actually come around when it comes to background checks and requirements and things like that. But if you're up to the challenge and interested, like I said, check out some more information below. And if there are any drivers to any of those companies out there, what are your thoughts on it? How do you feel about it? And what have you seen when driving on one of those platforms? Comment below and share your experiences. All right, that's the end of the video. Just wanted to share a few different platforms that drivers can get on to make extra money if it's available in your area and you do meet the requirements, as well as another option for families to be able to get around if they don't have the time for it. And if you have any questions specifically about these, just visit the websites. Like I said, I don't drive for any of them. I just wanted to share and pass the information along just because it is a different option for those who are seeking it. All right, sound off in the comments, subscribe, and ring the bell for notifications so you'll be notified when new videos do come out. And as always, never drink and drive, always tip your drivers, delivery drivers, and your shoppers, and we'll see you next time.